Well, we did it. I thought about it for a little while. I was up for so long the other night doing some research and acquiring everything I needed to get into the deeper mining experience. And boy, do we have a lot of information to go over today, so stay tuned.
Nerdy Dude Stuff.
What's going on, everyone? Welcome back to another video about pretty much like mining. I mean, Bitcoin, cryptocurrency, helium, all that good stuff. But today we are going to be talking about the deeper network. For those of you first time finding my channel, please take a moment to consider hitting that subscribe button, turn on the bell notification, as we do videos weekly and we do a stream every Monday. As a reminder, we have our first meetup event that we are hosting on September 22nd at 8 p.m. at Paddy Wagon Irish Pub. If you're in the area or you're relatively close and you want to stop by and have a couple of beers and talk about the Helium Network and see if your miner's pretty good, we're going to bring our laptop. There's going to be a discounted beer, which is the Wicked Weed Coastal Love IPA. All you do is walk up to the bar and say, hey, I want the nerdy beer for the night, and they're going to give you a discount on pretty much every time you order that beer. So if you guys are in the area, I'd certainly love to hang out. If you're not, I don't want you guys to invest a lot of money to come down and hang out, because it's just kind of like a test phase. But as we get bigger on YouTube, maybe one day I can come to you guys and we can do a meetup in your town. So yes, we just got our Deeper Mini, the silver one, in the mail. And it was sent to us from a subscriber, so thank you very much, Mr. P. I really appreciate it that you can give me this opportunity to start filming some content and jump into this project, even though I was a little hesitant to pull the trigger, but here it is. So, it is completely sealed up. It comes in this nice little box right here with all the serial codes, bar numbers, blah, 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 blah. Let's bust this bad boy open, get our trusty little knife. Don't do this at home if you're not supervised by an adult. With as much beer as we drink on this channel, I don't know why I don't have my wife supervising me while I do this. So let's see how this goes. Hopefully I don't have to edit out any footage. Ah, there we go. Maybe we got it. We'll leave the knife there just in case. Let's go ahead and rip that box open, because we're not reusing this. We're not reselling it on eBay. Rah, there we go. So we got our box nice and ripped open there. Let's plop it open. And it comes with a nice little instruction manual, which we've watched a bunch of YouTube videos, and we kind of know exactly how we need to do that. And then here is the model itself, this cute little deeper miner. Rawr, rawr, rah, blah, 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 blah. There we go. We got it nice and open, and you could see maybe it's got the deeper logo right there etched in there. It's about, I don't know, like 4 inches by like 2.5 inches by about 3/4 of an inch tall. We've got an Ethernet port on one side, another Ethernet port on the other side. We've got a USB-C port right here, and then we have another USB port there. Now, this is actually the mining mini version. So if you go onto the website, they have ones for $2.99, which are the consumer mini miners or mini DPN thingamabobs, but they are not the actual miners. So then we have our USB-C power supply, which we'll plug into our wall, and we're going to go and get this set up, and then we're going to come back and talk about it a little bit more. So stay tuned, guys. They sell you the dream of the deeper miner being a plug and play, easy to go device, but the past 2 hours have been freaking excruciating. Luckily, with the power of the internet and magic, you don't have to experience that. So, let's go with the setup that I did, because I'm going batshit insane right now. So you have a couple of options. One option is you have your modem, then you can plug your modem directly into your deeper miner, and then you can plug your deeper miner into your router, and then you can use your router to send internet to the rest of your shit. Unfortunately, that option didn't work for me, because I believe my Nighthawk has some features where I have to enable VPN services, but every time I was trying to do that, it would say enable DDNS and then set up a static IP address, which I've already set up for the Helium Mining Network. So the next option that I did was I have my modem, and then I send the modem to my router, and then I send my router connection to everything else, Wi-Fi and all that jazz, and then I did a little tiny Ethernet port to my deeper miner. And then I did my deeper miner with an Ethernet port to a laptop so I can access that. That's option B. If we did option A, any computer on the network could access the deeper miner. But since I had to go through modem to router to deeper miner to my hardwired laptop, only the laptop plugged into, it's a laptop, deeper miner, laptop, only the laptop plugged into the deeper miner can access the settings, and we're gonna take a look at those right now. Because I don't have my deeper connected to this computer, which I film everything on, I had to do cell phone pictures that I uploaded here, so I'm sorry about the potato quality. I don't have screen capturing. I use my work laptop, so of course I don't have anything installed on that. So the first thing you're going to do as soon as you have your deeper miner connected, whether you're going through the modem or through the router to the PC to whatever, is you're going to want to pull up an internet browser and you're going to want to type in 11.22.33.44. It's going to take you to this screen right here that you see on screen. Your username and your password for the first time is going to be admin all lowercase, and the password is admin all lowercase. So again, username admin, password admin, all lowercase. As soon as you get logged in, I recommend on the left-hand side scrolling all the way down to change your password. The next thing that you're going to want to do as soon as you get in there, you're going to want to go onto the left-hand side to device, then to system, and then go all the way over here to the right and where it says auto upgrade. And I recommend you have that on yes, because anytime anything comes out, they're going to automatically upgrade your deeper miner so that way you can continue to miner the DPR tokens. The last thing that you're going to want to do is go over on the left-hand side, and there's an option for DPN. Go down to Tunnel, and then you're going to notice that you have North America right here. I selected it, and then all the way on the right-hand side, you have an option to delete. Delete that North America tunnel. If you're in a different country than in your country's listed, delete your tunnel, because that is going to severely throttle your actual like internet speed. Regardless, like if you're going from modem to DPN to router, that's going to throttle your internet speed. I did this regardless, even though I'm going modem router to DPN connector to my laptop, but this is the number one thing that I recommend from all the research that I've done. All right. The last thing we want to do before we start getting into staking and all that stuff, and if you're planning to use your deeper mini or nano or anything like that to mine, is you want to go into the option over on the left hand side of the screen saying DPN, go down to mode, and you want to set your DPN to smart root. That is going to be the best thing that you can do for mining, where you're going to be, you know, providing your bandwidth, and it's going to read your bandwidth so that way you can build your credit score in mine and so on and so forth. So don't forget to do that as well. This shit is making my head spin, so give me a second. Let's continue on to staking. So this screen you'll see in a moment, but the first thing that you're going to want to do is decide on how much DPR tokens you want to stake. The reason why I say that is because the more you stake, the more you're going to have a higher credit score, and the higher credit score that you have, the more tokens you're going to earn. So this is not a true staking where you just set up the miner and you just earn tokens. This is where you have to stake tokens, we'll get a credit score, and then earn what the mining rewards are. So the very, very minimum is going to be 5,000 DPR tokens. And the reason why on screen it shows 6,000 DPR tokens is because you have to do an extra 1,000 DPR tokens on top of whatever your stake level you want to get past a 1 month wait list. So if you want to stake 5,000 tokens, you have a month to before you're going to earn. If you want to go to the next credit level and stake 10,000 DPR tokens and not 11,000, you're still going to have a month to wait before you can start earning. So if you stake 6,000, you skip to the head of the line. 11,000, skip to the head of the line. 21,000, skip to the head of the line. So on and so forth. Also, if you're just setting up the miner and you don't have any DPR tokens, you're more than welcome to just run and sell, we're going to say sell your bandwidth to earn the credit score, but it's going to take you about 200 days to earn that credit score to start getting token rewards. So if you want to get to the front of both lines, then you want to consider getting some tokens. The best place that you can get tokens, the link is in the description for this, is on the MEXC exchange. If you've been following my channel, this is also the best place where you can get Yieldly tokens, but on the cheap and on the down low, you can get tokens on MEXC. You don't have to worry about going through Uniswap with the exorbitant Ethereum gas fees or anything like that. You can go on to MEXC right now, where the DPR token is currently selling for just shy of 12 cents. Now, I do want to give you a heads up that if you purchase 6,000 DPR tokens directly, you want to make sure you purchase 267 additional, because there is a 267 DPR token transaction fee fee to transact and send them to your MetaMask wallet. You want to also make sure that your MetaMask wallet has about $25 in Ethereum to cover the gas fee to do the staking. Okay? All right. With that out of the way, if you want to get into staking, once you get started, you're going to want to pull up your device and register it, and you're going to go to device.deeper.network. Once again, that's device.deeper.network. On that, you're going to see the screen here where you can sign in with your email, an image code, which you'll see there, a verification code, which you're not going to do right away with your email because you only have 60 seconds for that verification code before it expires, and you have some other work that you have to do before you do that. You're going to do your password, you're going to create your password, and then you're going to input your MetaMask address or your Trust Wallet or your Wallet Connect address. I'm using MetaMask, so I put my MetaMask wallet address right here. And then you're going to need your register login and your serial number. To get your register login, we're going to go back to that screen where we first connected with the 11.22.33.44, which I have a picture of that up right here. And there is going to be a device number right underneath your username and password. Copy that down and save it. That's going to be where you're going to input that information. The next that you want is your serial number. So as soon as you pull up your device in that login, once you log in and change your password, you're going to be under device, then system, and then this hardware information right here, this deeper.wire.igg, and then a bunch of numbers and kabla, that is going to be your device's serial number. So then you are going to input that into register login, and then register login code, and then register SN. After you do that, you hit submit. Now we're going to go into my screen here, where I believe, nope, not that one. So in my screen here, where you're going to commit to how much you're going to stake. Now, I am going to commit to staking 21,000 DPR, and I'm going to be getting that 300 credit score, which is going to give me a 35% APR. Let's pull up our math right here. 2100 times 0.35 equals 7,350 tokens annually divided by 365. So I'm going to be getting about 20 tokens a day, which is currently at 12 cents. So that's $2.41 a day. But if we were doing that at times 0.35, so we're going to be getting 7,350 tokens a year times 0.12. At the current price, it's $882 a year. That's a really bit of a slow grind, but these tokens that you are going to lock up and commit into the staking pool right now are going to be for 9 months. And during that 9 months, your credit score will increase, the token value will increase. But after the 9 months, if I unlock my 21,000 tokens, then my credit score will automatically drop back 300 points, but it will stay wherever my credit has been earned for the mining. I will do a longer video on this in the future. This is just a setup and set it and forget it and go type video. As of right now, I am 54 cents in Ethereum shy of covering the gas fee to stake 21,000 DPR to start my mining right now. Oh my gosh, it's so dumb. I'm really, the one reason why I was really hesitant to get into DPR was because it's all on ERC20 and the Ethereum network, and I'm really sick of the gas fees. This is why I'm pumping Algorand so hard, because that's where you need to be. I'm so excited for these bad boys because that's built on the Algorand network, whereas right now I have to pay $16 to stake my DPR tokens, and I'm probably going to have to pay $16 to pull them out, and I find that absolutely ridiculous. This video today has been a crash course on unboxing, setting up your DPR mini, and then actually doing a very base setup. So I encourage you to watch it a few times. I covered all the information you need to actually get to the point where you're staking your tokens and getting into the mining process. But we didn't do a big solid breakdown of each and every little bit. So in the near future, we're going on vacation tomorrow for about 5 days. And then when we come back, we are going to take little bits of this video and break it down in the future for longer videos, you know, where we take a 2-minute section and make it a 13-minute video. So that way you guys can understand it. So with all that said, I am currently waiting to do some transactions to get my extra 54 cents in Ethereum over so I can get my shit staked, and then I can go from there, and we're going to let it run and let it go. But if you guys have any questions, comments, or concerns, feel free to reach out to me on Telegram, Twitter, or Discord. Links for all that stuff is in the description below of this video. Even though I'm going to be on vacation, it's from my real job. I will still have my phone on me, and I'll respond to you guys as I get the messages. Just don't be upset if I don't immediately. But without further ado, with all that said, anywho, thank you very much for watching. Please like, comment, subscribe, turn on the bell notifications, all that good stuff. I'm Oprius, and we'll see you guys next time. The fun thing about recording two videos in one day is that you do two different beer of the days, but with all the shit that I had to go through to learn how to do this DPR mining to do this video today, we had to actually get to another beer. So yes, we're a little bit tipsy, but the beer for the end of the video is a vanilla pumpkin beer brought to you by O'Fallon Brewery, and oh man, tis the season for pumpkin beers, and I love it. So cheers to you guys. We'll see you soon.